Hello everyone, and welcome again to Nettle, the best platform around for distance learning in business, finance, economics, and much, much more. My name is Sava, and today we're continuing our discussion of various value-at-risk tools and how we can improve over the original value-at-risk framework to account for some of its limitations. Today, we are going to address one of the limitations of the historical simulation value-at-risk. Well, as you know, for value-at-risk using historical simulation, we just look at the historical empirical distribution of returns and try to make an assumption that the past pretty much going to repeat in the future, so history repeats itself. And one of the limitations associated with this line of reasoning is that, well, the observations that occurred a long time ago are perhaps less relevant to the present and all the more so for the future than the observations that has been very recent. To account for that, there is a very neat approach that has been developed in 1997 by Boudoukh, Richardson, and Whitelaw, and it is called BRW, Historical Simulation Value-at-Risk, for first letters of the surnames of the authors that developed the approach. So BRWVAR utilizes the logic of the exponential moving average, and it discounts the observations that occurred long time ago by a constant factor lambda to preserve this logic that recent observations have more weight, they are more relevant for what might happen in the near future. So without further ado, what we need to account for first is the recency of each of our return observations. So here we have again the returns of S&P 500 over the past 5 years, and here we have the most recent observation available, 31st December 2019, and the least recent available is the observation for the 2nd of January 2015. So this is going to be the most recent observation, so let's assign it a value of 0, and here will assign the previous return a value of 1, and then we can just select those two cells and drag them upward until we hit the top. And we see that we have this nice pattern that the less recent the observation is, the higher is this number. Then let's just copy the return distribution and paste it as values over here. Then let's rank it from smallest, so from most extreme losses, to largest, so to most extreme gains. So we'll go to data, sort by column E, which are ranked returns, and sort them on cell values smallest to largest. And that will rearrange the data so that we have the most extreme losses at the top and the most extreme gains in the bottom, and these will have the corresponding recency parameters alongside the respective returns. Now we need to apply the weighting factors given our predetermined value of lambda for our BRWVAR so that we could account for recency and treat recent observations as more relevant and very remote observations as less relevant. So that requires us to pick a value of lambda. A value of lambda should be between 0 and 1, and it will correspond to the exponential moving average, so to the decay of relevance as we move from recent observations to very remote observations. It should be slightly close to 1, so most commonly you'll see a value of lambda from 0.97 to somewhere around 0.995. So let's pick a value of lambda of 0.99. And the weighting factor would be the value of lambda, and we need to lock that, to the power of the recency parameter. So we'll raise lambda to the power of the recency parameter, and we'll get the relative importance of each of the observations to our ultimate value at risk calculation. So we'll bottom right click it all the way down and see that the observations that are more recent, for example, this is the 96th most recent observation, has a higher weight than some observation that occurred long, long time ago. Now we need to adjust each of those observations by the sum of those weighting factors so that the total sum of those will be equal to 1, so that we can treat this as the empirical distribution of sorts. So we'll need to sum over all of the weighting factors. We'll get a value that's very close to 100. That's no coincidence. Now we need to divide each of the weighting factor by this sum. And we need to lock the sum because we'll drag it around. And then we bottom right click it all the way down and see that indeed the sum of the weighting factors is equal to 1. Now, as we have our returns ranked, we can calculate the cumulative sum of adjusted weighting factors to have our pseudo-empirical distribution function. So at first, we'll just have the adjusted weighting factor, and then to get the cumulative, we'll just add to the previous value the current value of the weighting factor. And we'll bottom right click it all the way down, and we'll see how this cumulative sum increases steadily and reaches 100% or 1 at the very end. So at the very highest extreme gain. Now we need to just copy the ranked returns across. And now we can finally apply both the conventional historical simulation VR as well as the BRW VR and compare the results. So for the historical simulation VR, as we all know, we'll just need to apply the percentile EXC, exclusive percentile function, for the array of returns. And our percentile would be just our confidence interval. For the BRW VR, we would need to look for the value in the cumulative empirical distribution that is close, as close as possible, to our confidence interval value. So for example, if we are looking for a 1% VR, we will look at the cumulative distribution function that we have generated using our lambda, our exponential decay of relevance, and pick a value that's as close to 1% as possible. So here we'll see that we have 0.99% and the next observation is 1.4%. So for a 1% BRW VR, we'll pick -2.71% as our 1% loss threshold. To apply it using a formula so that we don't have to look and pick an observation manually, we can use the VLOOKUP function. So to do so, we need to find the value of our confidence interval. So we need just to select the whole table with the column of the cumulative distribution function and the respective returns. And we need to lock that so that it doesn't change as we move from cell to cell, as we drag the formula around. Then the column index number is 2 because we want to return a data point from the second column with ranked returns. And here, with the range lookup, we want an approximate match because we might not find the exact value of 5% or 1% or whatever you might have in the first column. So enforcing that formula and dragging it down, we can compare the BRW VR and the historical simulation VR and see how different they are, comparing them for different confidence intervals. So most of the time, the BRW VRs are quite small in terms of absolute magnitude, and we might conclude that that's because some of the most extreme losses have occurred remotely in the past, so the BRW VR treats them as less relevant to the present and recent future. And we can also see that our initial consideration that 1% BRW VR should be equal to 2.71% is indeed true. That's exactly how this function works. And we can also try various values of lambda and see how will it change the results. So if we reduce lambda, so we have even a higher bias towards more recent observations. So for example, we'll pick a lambda of 0.97, then we'll see that the VAR for BRW decreases in terms of absolute magnitude even more so, which again reinforces our hypothesis that that's due to the fact that extreme losses have mostly occurred remotely in the past. If we would estimate this model on the data that has extreme losses occurring very recently, then the situation would be the reverse. And if we increase lambda to something like 0.997, so very close to 1, then we'll see that the BRW VAR and the historical simulation VAR are now almost a perfect match. Because as you move closer to 1 with your lambda, you move closer to the original historical simulation VAR, because obviously the historical simulation VAR is equivalent to a BRW VAR with lambda of 1 when you do not discriminate between observations that occurred recently or remotely in the past. And that's all there is for BRW VAR and modifying the historical simulation approach to account for the recency bias. Please leave a like under this video if you found it helpful. In the comments below, please suggest any other topics in business, economics, or finance that you would want me to investigate in future videos. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thank you very much, and goodbye.